Let us all kneel down as we pray. Our kind and gracious Father, we'd like to thank you for the beautiful morning and beautiful Sabbath that you've given us. I'd like to thank you for bringing us all together here to come and worship you. This morning, as we start this Sabbath school, I ask that you be with us, talk through us, and hasten those people that are still coming so that we should be together. We ask that you should help us observe your Sabbath this day as you commanded us to do. I pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Our Sabbath school theme this morning is Does Jesus Care? Does Jesus Care? In the midst of the struggles, the pain, and all the uncertainties that we face each and every day, it's natural to wonder, does Jesus truly care in our individual circumstances? Does he care? Does he care that I'm sick? Does he care that you've lost a baby? Does he care that you've lost a job? Do you think God cares about each and everyone in our individual capacities, in our individual circumstances? We ask the same questions as the Samidu sisters. The first one, my name is Podamina. On my far left, that is Saina, she's the second born. And on the middle, that's Adbele, she's the last born in our family. Our mother died when I was 11, she was 8, and she was 5. And we asked that question, does Jesus really care? How are we going to grow up? What is going to become of us? What is going to happen to us? Who is going to take care of us? How are we going to get educated? We asked Jesus, and we were kids, but I can only imagine the siblings of my mother, what was going through in their heads. How are we going to make sure that we feed these children, we fed for them, and we provide for them? And I'm sure they asked that question a lot more than we did because we were kids. All we cared for was whether we were going to get shelter and food. But they wondered quite a lot because she died when we were very young. And so yes, we do ask Jesus, do you really care about us? And even Jesus himself, he asked the Lord, Lord, why have you forsaken me? Job also questioned God when he was going through all those difficulties that he went through, as you all know. So we do ask Jesus, we do ask God when we face different circumstances or difficulties, does Jesus really care? We'll find out if he does care. Right now, I'll ask the Gumpumula family to give us one song. We outsourced the Gumpumula family because the sisters we couldn't sing.
Yes. Does Jesus care? Do you think he cares? I have a testimony for you this morning. How when I lost my health, this is when I was in Form 3. And at our school, for the past 2 years, Form 1 and Form 2, people were not allowed to go home even when they were sick. You just had to go to the hospital, then back at school in sick bay, and that was it. But when I was in Form 3, rules were a little bit softer because of some circumstances. What happened at school, and people now, when they were sick, they were going home. I was in the first term, and during study hours in the evening, I just felt I'm so weak, I want to sleep, my body's in pain. And it just came at an instant, I was thinking, what is happening? So I went to the rooms to sleep. The next morning I wouldn't get up. I was very, very weak. And fortunately enough, they managed to call my parents and they came to pick me out. At the hospital, I was diagnosed with malaria 4+. So I was home about 2 weeks. And I recovered, and I went back to school. Second term happened the same. So sick. They came to pick me up. Again, malaria 2+. I stayed home for 2 weeks, back to school. Third term comes, sick again. Home, malaria 2+. I went to school. And after maybe a month, I got sick again, went home, malaria, I was home again. After I recovered, I went back to school. It was a tough year. But when I think now, I realize that Jesus cared for me for that particular year. If the rules were still rigid, I wouldn't know, maybe I wouldn't have made it. But this year, they allowed us to go home when we were sick, and I got the medical care that I wanted. So I believe that Jesus cared for me for that particular year. Even now, when I got sick, I still remember that time, that if Jesus cared for me that particular year, he can also care for me now. And I'm telling you, my brethren, that even if now you've lost your health, maybe employment, or whatever it is that we are passing through, because we all know that we are passing through difficult times these last days, we should know that Jesus came. I have a verse for you. That's 1 Peter 5. Verse 6 and 7, and it reads, therefore, humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, and that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you. So our Jesus cares for us even in our lowest moments. He cares for us, and here is a verse for you that you can claim that he cares for you. Even a quotation from Ellen G. White, it says, he have nothing to fear for the future, except as we shall forget the way the Lord has led us and his teaching in the past history. The way where we are coming from, the Lord has done so many things for us. So that should give us hope that today going forward, the Lord will take care for us as well. Amen.
Does Jesus care? That's our theme this Sabbath book. Does Jesus care? Yes, it's a resounding yes. He does care. Like I said, for those that have just joined us, we were very young when we lost our mother. She was 5, but look at her. She has a kid of her own. At that time, 25 years ago, I'm sure we didn't know how she was going to grow up. But Jesus cared for us. I'm going to read Matthew 6, verse 26. Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? So this is just to encourage us that if God can take care of things that cannot fend for themselves, cannot work for themselves, how much more his people, who he created us, how much more is he going to take care of us? So we thank God that he has seen us through, and we got educated through the people that surrounded us. God blessed us with a very loving family, parents, uncles, aunties. So we never lacked. We were given everything. We were sent to school. We are all educated. We are all graduates. I'm an accountant. She's an accountant. She's a nurse. So God was so gracious to us. But then we doubted God. We doubted him. That how are we going to get through life? How are we going to make it in life? But right now here, this is a testimony that Jesus indeed cares for us. And whatever that you're going through in life, do not despair. Like she read in the verse that she read from 1 Peter, do not despair. God will take care of you. Right now, I ask Mai to offer another song. We also outsourced another service.
Why should I feel discouraged? Why should the shadow come? Why should my heart feel lonely and long for the rest of all? When Jesus Sparrow.
And Samaria and to the end of the mission, and where we become a blessing when we mission to others. And the one example that I've given us in the quarterly is about Abraham, where he left his family and to go to the land where he knew not. Our visitors who are worshiping with us the first time, we don't have visitors today. Okay, before we pray, I call the Sabbath school superintendent, then I'll pray after her.
Happy Sabbath, Church.
Amen.
Thank you, Samidu sisters, and the absorbed Kumkuma family. You have blessed us. Thank you so much. We've been blessed, isn't it?
Amen.
Amen. Let's give them a big amen.
Amen.
Since we don't have visitors, we all know where to go. May those who are leading stand as they offer a word of prayer.
Let us bow our heads for a word of prayer. Our loving Father, we thank you for your love, and we thank you for all that you give for us. We thank you for the gift of life, for the Sabbath book, for the opportunity for us to present the Sabbath book. We thank you for for we know that you were with us and that you guided us through. We pray that you be with us throughout the day as we are going to our classes to hear more about you through our lessons. We pray that you be with each and every one of us. For our prayer of blessing, the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Amen. Amen.